What's up, everybody? My name is Sergeant Manley, and this is American Truck Simulator Multiplayer. We've got Mr. RuntGaming, YourGrace, and way over there with the trailer is Hooser. We're going to be hanging out, having a little bit of fun, and hopefully get some good content for you guys. So, let's get to it.
Scaring the hell out of this fella sitting in the parking lot on a bunch of concrete culvert.
They don't give a single shit. You're fine.
Yeah, he's used to trucks coming here and not being able to drive.
All right, buddy. I'm going to go and wait for you because your trailer is done the old thing where they put a trailer in a trailer kind of deal. So.
Yeah. All
right, so where are you at, Runt? Plaster and Sons?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, I hit it first time go. Look at that.
All right, I'm going to start making my way out of here.
Making my way downtown.
And I'm taking a right out of Plaster and Sons, so...
Okay.
Almost be with you guys just collecting it now. Oh, parking brake, that's needed, indeed.
Third try on me.
Third time's a charm.
Three tag. That's what I'm going to start calling my little groups that I do stuff. I'm just going to call it three tack.
Oh, that's what I did on my YouTube
you
channel.
Do you have enough room there, or do you want me to back up?
No. I should have enough room.
I'll back up just in case.
Yeah, I'm...
Alright.
Okay, yeah, Walbert. Looks like you go eastbound out of Walbert, and you'll run into me. There's actually a fuel stop. Well, for our British fella, a petrol stop on the way past me. Because we don't want you to have the same thing happen as the first episode we did, where you're like, guys, I don't know if I have enough fuel to make it.
Oh, definitely not. No, that was an issue. I mean, I must have been running on air that day. I don't know how.
I think I see Hoosier.
Yep.
Right, I got my trailer, guys. Just pulling out now, and then I'll be with you guys.
Yep, and for everybody watching my video, this is an experiment. I know I have my mirrors up. I'm actually running my game in my normal resolution, but I'm trying to get it to where you guys see, and I'm trying to be cognizant of what I'm looking at. So I'm basically trying to focus my center monitor on what you guys see, so I'm trying to... keep a lookout that way, but I still see peripheral the way I want to. So I'm going to see if this works any better as far as translation from my gameplay to YouTube. So where the hell are you going, Grace?
Oh, I'm following the map, aren't I? My bad. We're out with you guys first, aren't we? Of course we are. Not an issue.
You need fuel. Fuel makes the world go round.
Yeah, actually, I haven't got a full tank.
I saw him take a right there. I was like,
No worries, I got this. Look at this magic
that's funny.
Stuff.
Where are you at, Manly?
Headed towards the highway.
Oh, dear. Glad you...
Right outside of the dealership.
Okay, yeah.
All right, here we go.
Pulling dealership is on the south side of the highway, yeah?
Highway downtown.
Are you going to take a left or a right out of here, Run?
I'm taking a right.
All right, then I'm not going to waste my time turning around.
Nope. Right-hand turn, and then right-hand turn, and then left-hand turn onto the highway, I think.
Yep.
Tank fuel, there we go.
Now, one of these days, I'll be able to afford a better wheel. Like I said, it's a significant expenditure for a wheel.
Oh,
so
they are ridiculously overpriced. Like I said, unbelievable.
Alrighty, right. I'm making a right-hand turn.
Ready when you guys are. We got to turn around. Okay.
No, we don't have to turn around. Trust me.
Oh, we don't. Okay.
There's a highway entrance up here.
Awesome.
Where is here?
We're going to, I want to say, the eastern side of Elko to get on the highway.
Okay. I was just wondering because I didn't see you guys in my tab menu anymore.
We're getting there. Basically, we're going on the Kenworth dealership side of Elko.
Okay.
We're on the east side of Elko. So if you're on the west highway entrance, we're headed to the east one.
Yeah, I'm over on east. Just about to get on the highway.
Yeah, I see you. You're 500 meters away. And for everybody that's curious how I know that, I actually have the tab menu pulled up in Trucker's MP. It just happens to be so far left that you guys aren't going to see it. So.
I was meant to ask, Ron, what are you doing in terms of the resolution for this one?
This one is going to be recorded at 1920 by 1080.
Right.
And it's going to be basically everything that's in the center of my monitor. So I've got both my mirrors pulled up there. However, that's not actually the mirror I'm using.
I'm thinking that would probably be best, to be honest.
Yeah, it wasn't that I wanted to make it uncomfortable for anybody, but to tell you the truth, I wasn't very cognizant of exactly how many of my viewers watched on mobile devices, which is my failure. I didn't realize, because I don't use my phone to watch videos. I use my computer. I use my television. I use other stuff to watch YouTube videos. And I have a Note 5, so I have a giant phone.
Mm-hmm.
So when I went to watch my video on my phone even, it wasn't that bad. However, I didn't think about it. I looked at my wife's phone, which she has an S7, and was like, oh, that's painful. So it wasn't that I was, unaware of this. Well, it was absolutely that I was unaware because I'm old school. I use a computer for most everything.
Oh, of course, red light. Good, there it is. All right, guys, I've got a red. So,
oh, I'll be waiting.
Yep, I'm. Manly, where did you go?
I'm on the side of the highway.
Oh, you're on the highway already? Oh,
mm-hmm.
We'll get out of town here eventually. I think we've hit every light that there is.
Tell me about it.
And then the on-ramp, of course, is uphill for Grace, so.
Yeah.
Have fun.
Don't even. I'm hoping I can build enough speed where I... Depends how fast you go, to be honest, will determine if I stall or not. No doubt you're going to deliberately go slow now.
No, I'm not. I'm going up the on-ramp to get on the highway. That's... A misconception a lot of people have about an on-ramp, and this is coming from a police perspective, is that the on-ramp is a yield lane, and it is. However, there should be enough on-ramp for you to get to speed to merge into traffic.
Mm-hmm.
Not stop at the end and cause a giant mess. So... I've actually got a big enough motor. I'm pulling hills pretty efficiently.
Yeah, tell me about
it. Oh, yeah, there you are.
Literally just taken off with your upgrades and all, but that's fine. Hopefully,
there you go, my doors.
After this one, I'll be able to get some upgrades as well on the go.
I'm already at 65, so.
I'm not used to you having that new engine, so I was kind of taking it easy for you. And then all of a sudden, there you are.
I got way station.
Look at this.
Alrighty, so slowing down for the way station. I've already blown it away.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, of course. I was hoping it would be generous, considering I've got the smaller engine. But like, yeah, it's alright, you go ahead, you get a bit of a head start. No, pull in at the way station. Yeah.
77,000 pounds.
3,000 lower than max, which is something I learned from Chip. actual weight allowance on highways is 80,000 pounds unless you're permitted. So.
Yeah, that was fine. 75.
I'm off to the south.
I think I'm going to have to use the high gears because this is just ridiculous right now.
Hoosier is coming up. Manly is right behind me.
That guy's probably wondering what we're doing.
Yeah, well, let him wonder.
Oh, what? I'm already in the high gear, god dang.
Oh, poor Grace.
Grace is coming up.
Yeah. I think I've just hit the jackpot sign there, back there.
Well, we're all going to have a stop, and it's a downhill stop, so...
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. Here we go, lads. I just actually got some speed up then, and now we're all coming to a stop. Always the way. Not to worry.
Oh, sign. Almost got it. Almost got it.
Just testing your skill there.
Mm-hmm. I cut the wheel too early. We got four little ducks lined up behind me like ducks.
That sounded good.
A little heavy coming down the hill?
Yeah, just a little bit. I actually had to use the emergency brake there. That was, oh, and I've taken out the stop. Look at that. I'll get myself back into this. I'm going to explain to my viewers that, I'm not the best.
Oh, that's... None of us are truck drivers.
No.
So that's where the entertainment comes in, because... The things that we do, not knowing, you know, the size of these machines is...
That's crazy. But I have a lot of fun with this game. I mean, it's great.
Like I said, the game, and I've said it in every video, the game is on the outside when you, you know, first look at the box. You're like, really?
Yeah.
And then you get the game and you're like, oh, I've got to get this wheel. I've got to do this. I've got to do that. I've got to, you know, like me, as soon as I got the game, I was like, oh, I've got to get more monitors. Because I've got to get to that point where it's like driving a real truck. So.
Yeah. Tell me about it. That's what made me want to get the steering wheel and the pedals and all that. Because it felt... I mean, the game was good, but I felt it would be better with this, and it is, without a doubt.
Well, I had somebody comment on one of my videos asking, especially it was my ETS video, or one of my ETS videos, they said, you know, playing with three monitors, does it make it more immersive? Absolutely, because
I'm
looking to my right now, and I see my door mirror where I see my steps, and I see my right mirror on the side of the truck. I see the glove box. You know, it's fantastic as far as, you know, the perception of actually driving the truck, and the size helps quite a bit rather than just locked down to one monitor. I think you could get the same effect relatively using track IR. Which is something I'm also thinking about, because with track IR like this, it would be much easier for me to...
I'm kind of intrigued how that would work, because you turn your head left, presumably to look left or check your mirror slightly, but because you've turned your head, how the hell are you meant to see the screen?
Well, it... what it does is it basically magnifies your movement.
Right.
So, turning your head 3 degrees, where you're still looking, basically you're looking at the, your face is facing the, you know, just left of center, but it magnified the turn of the player head inside the game or the camera to where you're actually looking out the door.
Right, okay, I'm with you.
And so that might be, that would be where I probably run into issues with track IR, because I move my head a lot when I'm talking. So if I were doing an ATS or ETS video, you would just see the camera bouncing everywhere as I talk.
Well, there's actually, almost like with a steering wheel setup or a controller setup, there's a dead zone that you can... I'm pretty sure. And then the other thing I'm thinking about doing is, a lot of people haven't heard of it, but for those that have, butt kicker. I looked at it for Flight Simulator when I was doing it, and I think butt kicker would just make this amazingly cool.
I think you explained to me what that was, but I've kind of forgot, so...
It's basically a low-frequency generator that you attach to your chair that...
Oh, close, yeah.
Basically, when you feel a bump in the road in the game, it sends it to butt kicker, and it actually, you know, shakes your chair just enough.
That's pretty awesome, yeah.
Very, very cool. I saw a butt kicker set up in a flight simulator and was like, oh, that's just, that's, you know, on my, my wish list of things. It's...
Oh, this thing is just terribly slow.
Now, ultimately, what I'd want to do is the same thing I wanted to do with Flight Simulator, and instead of being sitting at a desk in a desk chair, is set up a actual kind of cockpit where, for lack of a better term, you're actually sitting in the truck cab.
Right. Oh, yeah, this is... legit on my screen.
What's that?
There's no train on my screen, so you're just sitting there.
You guys just drove through the train on my screen.
Oh, well. Not everything's perfect. Not in a world like this.
Oh, there it is. Opens up, lets two trucks pass, then in a magically another... Oh, what? Literally a train just drove right through the back of his trailer there. What? He's legit.
Always.
I'm trying to pick a gear. I'm 30 miles an hour in this truck is just not happy with any even gear.
Oh, dude, it takes me about 3 years to get to 30 mile an hour. Consider yourself lucky.
Well, you know you can skip gears. I generally on a load like this, I'm not super heavy, especially with the engine that I've got. I'll start out in third.
Yeah, and that's usually what I'm doing.
I start out fifth and jump 2 gears at a time.
So wow. I jump 3 from third.
That's...
because I can wrap out to 15 grand, 15,000.
Pretty much what I do.
1500,
yeah.
I should say. I hit 1500 before I hit 10 miles an hour.
Mm-hmm.
It's
I started
just
out
enough to get the truck rolling.
I started out in fourth just then and shifted before I even got to 5 miles an hour.
Mm-hmm. Once I get to 12, I generally go up single gears, but crap. 4 over. Where's
7?
Where's the small town cop that's pulled me over like Roscoe in the Dukes of Hazzard so I can do a concert?
How did you guys get so many upgrades so soon? That's what I wanted to ask.
We've been playing a lot.
You've been playing a lot, right?
Yeah, we
off camera.
Yeah, off camera.
Okay. I might have to spend a couple of hours then.
A friend was nice enough to give me enough money to get a good, decent truck. It's not fully upgraded yet, but yeah.
Well, the way we started our accounts, and Grace was there when we did it, was we got a save game that had $1 billion on it. So we could basically buy anything we came across. And if we, you know, get hit for speeding or blowing a red light or whatever, that's fine. But we've upgraded our trucks naturally because we started out at level one. As far as truck capacity and capability, we were able to haul from one end of the map to the other because it also gave us the all of the like fragile cargo and so forth. But very organic as far as the truck goes. I just think it may have been during my live stream that I was able to finally get enough levels under me to get a sleeper on this thing.
Yeah, I think it was.
But it's hard to tell because I don't record all of these sessions. I'm actually, that's one of the things I'm going to kind of pride myself on the Euro Truck is I've started from profile creation. I haven't done anything on that profile specifically offline.
Gonna have to go ahead and play that with you guys at some point, definitely.
Manly was telling me I'd like to do some multiplayer with that.
Yeah.
As well. But for sure. Something about the multiplayer 40 mile an hour speed.
This thing is just taking forever to climb.
Yeah, with Euro Truck Simulator,
the US server is crap.
The American Truckers MP server just, like, you can't even connect to it.
Right.
It'll put you in the game, but it'll automatically start you offline.
Alright, okay. So you have to actually put in the Euro.
So. But Piosh is going to be a drive around. I'm not driving through the town.
Oh, no.
That.
Most definitely.
Oh, hang on a minute. Good lord. Yeah, I would agree. Drive a go round, to be honest.
Well, we don't need fuel. We don't need to sleep.
No, I'm good.
And it's not that many miles out of the way to just go around.
Yeah, I would agree.
With fewer turns. Speed limit sucks going around, but hey. Can't have your cake and eat it too.
Well, you can. You've just got to steal it.
Well, I was trying to be nice. Alright. 70 miles an hour. Not that I'll get there, but...
Oh dear. Is it, 70 up here, did you say?
Yeah.
Alrighty. I'm still in the 30 right now, so I'm gonna assume.
And there's a few hills leaving out of town, so you're gonna wanna probably there's pick up 70. Speed a little early.
Yeah, I am.
Put the hammer down and try to get some momentum up.
Nope, there's 65. I'm dead.
Yep. Do your best to get your momentum up and go for it. So.
Oh, this truck is honestly.
Oh, I remember that episode number 2 where I had the 40,000 pound trailer and the 300 horsepower engine. I was like, oh, really?
Oh, yeah. That was... It's painful, isn't it? It is honestly painful.
Well, yeah. I mean, especially like an on-ramp or something like that when you're running a 13-speed gearbox. You're like, pull the hill. Pull the hill, please. I'm actually really surprised that my fuel economy is showing. I'm over 6 miles of the gallon, which is from what I understand. Like I said, I'm not a driver, but I do know that I've talked to Chip quite a bit. That says 6 miles of the gallon is damn good in a truck.
I'm at 5.9.
I'm at 5.4.
Ooh. Killing it, brother.
Well, I'm pretty heavy on the accelerator. Even in real life, I would just rather get to the speed limit and stay there than I would, you know, take time to get there.
Well, I try to do what Chip says. He says 1500 RPM is about the shift point that you want. You know, and when you're on the road, actually top gear flat out, 1500 RPM. Whatever that speed is in your top gear is where you want to be at. That's basically the butter zone for most bang for your buck, if that makes sense.
I've been shift.
Now you cut out. Poof, gone.
Rip.
Yep.
Who is this? Oh, no lag. There it is. Went to go overtake someone, and then that's it. Apparently they're way ahead of me. Oh, yeah. I think I'm pretty much flat out in this thing right now. Yep, 64 miles per hour.
There it is. We've actually discovered, Grace, that external contracts through World of Trucks limit your speed.
Oh, they do?
To 65 miles an hour, yeah.
That's interesting.
That's a growing pain that we found out. So if you want to be able to pull a truck flat out, or pull a trailer flat out, you need to go through the freight market in the game.
That's interesting. I wonder why they do that now.
I don't know. You guys are with me making the turn back there.
Yep.
Yep. I'm.
Yeah, I think we're all relatively close to each other.
You guys are. I'm almost a mile ahead of everybody.
All right.
Yep.
No, I took some extra time making that turn back there so I could get some distance from you.
Oh, here we go.
Uh-oh.
No, I was getting some speed up. It's finally. Gee.
Yep, we got a truck coming at us.
I'll probably honk the horn there.
Well, my horn got stuck because I hit. What does Y do? It basically locks me down to where I can't do anything.
Well, I've set my Y to my my lights. So.
No, Y on the keyboard.
Oh, right. Okay. Not sure.
I don't know. I don't think I've ever.
I think I have that as my chat.
Well, Y blacks out bottom two-thirds of my screen.
Yeah, Y is the chat.
Oh. Well, that's probably why I can't do anything else. 40. Jeez. Coming into Phoenix.
Turns like a house.
I'm trying my best not to slow down right now. Okay.
Not Phoenix.
Oh, I'm gonna have to let off the gas now, aren't I? Here I am. Yeah, and there's the speed limit. God.
Yeah, if you guys can't keep up with me doing 30 through the city, then there's something up.
Well, I mean, I am keeping up. I'm just not wanting to really overtake. There's no need.
No.
May as well keep.
That's one of the things I've noticed about the online players on the server. It seems like everybody's in such a hurry to go everywhere. It's like, mm-hmm. I've got to get there as quick as I can. Instead of enjoying the scenery and all that, I mean, that's part of the fun, is the scenery and seeing the way that SCS built the cities and
well, it's in the realism such. As well. You won't overtake if, you know, you're not allowed or you don't need to, you know, especially for a town. A truck wouldn't be overtaken. But I've seen people do it.
I'm trying to let this light change without me getting there. Still keep rolling a little bit.
Yeah, that's fine.
But it doesn't look like it's...
Gentle roll.
It did cooperate.
Hey, look at that.
You watch, it'll be red by the time I get there. I know, we're all right.
You're going to be so lucky on the next one.
We're all right.
Nope, not so lucky.
Nope. Oh, come on.
Oh, yellow. Gorgeous.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Funny.
I stopped a quarter way through the intersection.
Yeah, I just about got that light back there. I mean, it started to change to yellow as I was going. I'd already went past the line, so not much I could do about that.
Well, here's the way yellow lights work, at least in the States, in every area that I ever worked in law enforcement. If you have entered the intersection on a yellow light prior to red, then you are clear to exit the intersection as the most expeditiously as you can. So a lot of people that think that you've run a red light by going through a yellow, no. So as long as you cross that stop stripe, basically, on a yellow light, you're good. And that's most places. I'll just say that. Well, that's that as it is.
I'll have to bet. Yeah, I have to bet that in mind, for sure. Okay, brake. God, Lord. Too busy moving the cables out of the way, and almost went into the back.
Well, I was in ninth gear before I cleared the intersection. That's crazy.
Yeah, so was I.
Think we're about to open up. And yep.
Right, I'm hitting every red light possible right now.
We're gonna get another one.
Yep.
There it is.
Just changed.
Okay.
You want me to slow down out of...
No, you're good.
Vegas? Because I'm already leaving Vegas at 50-some miles an hour.
Oh, Lord.
Yep, I'm already out of town.
Mm-hmm.
No, I think we're good. Another light, though.
Oh.
I felt that.
Sorry.
Yeah.
Love tap.
Yeah.
Yeah, Grace, we were talking about how many upgrades I've got lately. Is the day of my live stream, I just needed some compression time where I got to just joy playing. I played the rest of the day, into the night, into the early morning of Sunday. So...
Right. Okay.
That's basically where I got all of my
I'm gonna go ahead and
I think I'm crossing the Hoover Bridge.
Play a little tomorrow, actually.
Was it Manly that set their speedometer or whatever, or bought a new truck or something and had tracked how many miles we went?
No, I've driven on ATS multiplayer. I'm not buying a new truck myself. I'm just going to upgrade this one as it comes along. Probably not the most frugal way to do it as far as in-game money, but I have more in-game money than I could ever spend. I've gone a total of 16,500 miles online.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, this thing, look at it.
So.
Yeah, this truck has 10,000 on it now.
So, Grace, how many miles are you sitting in on that truck? Because you bought your truck the same day I bought mine, basically.
Yeah, I did, didn't I? Is it, what's it under there, F6?
No, it's going to be on your actual dash.
Oh. Oh, right, okay, yeah, I'm on about 23.
23 what?
2,365. Oh, wow.
Almost 3,000. You've done 3,000 miles?
Yeah.
I've done five times as much as you have.
Yeah, well.
Six?
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's where the upgrades on my truck have come from.
I thought it would be more than that. That's why I read it as 23. I thought, no.
I'm at 73,000 right now.
Good lord. It feels like I've done more than that, but maybe not.
Well, and the scale is so small for these maps.
And I think in 1.4, which came out today, yes?
Yesterday.
Sometime last week. Came out yesterday.
Mm.
1.4, didn't they rescale the map in that one, or no? Or is that just the steering wheel add-on?
I don't know.
I don't actually know. What is 1.4? What have they done in that? Do we know?
I know the steering wheel adjustments, where you can basically move your steering wheel up, down, and in and out.
Oh, really? That's awesome.
Yeah. Right. I really can't wait till that gets put into multiplayer. And it's also in ETS 2. So both of those got updated to that. But it broke some mods and stuff. Because for some reason, like in-cab physics, I was reading on the forums, said that ATS... Oh, crap. 55. 35. None of them. That was quick.
Oh, shit.
25.
Oh, that is really fast.
70 is my max in this. Seems
flying through. Whoops.
Yep. Yeah, 20, 24, 30, 34. There it is.
Oh.
Is that the trip distance now? Is it said trip distance?
Oh, red light.
Yeah, I got the next one. And I just pegged out my speedometer. I'm trying to blow my truck up. Mm. Or my tack. I wrapped it out to like over $3,000. Oops.
I got waste station again.
Do you change anything on the dash there with the display?
No. It's just going to be, you know, a number and then MI for miles.
Yeah, I got that, but it says trip distance. Assuming that's it. That's what I got mine anyway.
There's a setting to where you can change that from trip to, and I don't remember what the key is. We'll have to look that up.
Oh, I didn't get pulled in for the way station, lol.
Talking about the setting to go through the dashboard display?
Well, that's I know that.
Oh, okay, but let me hit that and see what that water temperature distance. Cruise control.
What I'm talking about is because you've got basically trip A, trip B, and your full odometer.
Oh yeah, you have to go in and set keys for that.
Yeah.
There is no default.
There we go, straight down to a 25. Look at that.
Yeah, it's quick.
Yeah. Tell me about it. Honestly, if I see a fuel station, probably gonna go ahead and seems to be absolutely guzzling it right now. Red light. God dang.
Oh, poor Grace.
Oh, and Grace, by the way, this is your first day back at work? Not first day, but first week?
Yeah, it is, yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. So that was a little bit of a hit.
Yeah, that 6 weeks went by really quick.
It did, didn't it, Just?
Because I remember you and I were talking about that. Your 6 weeks vacation started basically the day we recorded our cunning stunts video.
Was it really? Wow.
I think. Around about that time frame.
Around about that time, yeah. It was about the 23rd, I think.
It wasn't that long ago. Six weeks goes by.
Oh, I'm struggling climbing this.
It was just short of when Jeff shouted out my champ. And it was...
Hang on. Whoever's behind me, hang on. I'm having a little bit of an issue. There we go. I thought I was going to stall it for a second then.
Oh. Yeah, I've got 160 miles to go as it stands right now.
It certainly did fly, tell you that for sure. And this week's been a hit to come back. I mean, having to adjust my sleeping pattern. I'm used to 6 weeks of getting it up at 12, going to bed at 2, 3 in the morning. Now I'm going to bed at 10:30 and getting up at... 5:45 in the morning, so...
Yeah, I am not a morning person.
Well, same. I don't think anybody that plays games is much of a morning person.
I would agree with
especially that. Especially if you have the capability to do, like, YouTube and stuff like me. Which is generally a pretty large point of contention with my wife and I, that, I need to be more adult and, go to bed at a decent hour so I can get up at a decent hour, which I agree with her. I mean, but there's just times where you're so close to getting a video finished editing or whatever else, or, pushed to get another video recorded and so forth, that makes it hard.
Well, that's it. That's why this week has just been, wanted to get stuff out there. And like I said, the other day, I am... was closing my eyes at the keyboard. I just got up and went downstairs, had an hour's nap, and that seemed to do the trick. I was all right after that.
That is what we call in the States a power nap.
Yeah. That's it.
Well, then a lot of people, I'm not going to tell anybody what you actually do, but what you do, it's not physically demanding, but it's planning demanding. A lot mental. So you have to always be kind of...
It drains me mentally. It's very tiring in that regard. It's the nature of the job. Because you say you worked in a similar field at one point?
Oh, yes. That's actually what my degree is in.
Oh, right, okay.
Is enterprise-level networking.
Right.
It's,
Oh, don't do this to me. Don't do this to me. He's stopped. There it is. There's the first stall of the episode, guys.
Hey, it took a lot longer than last time.
Oh, look at this crap.
Well, I'm giggling at Grace, who has installed his truck. However, the steering wheel and pedal that I'm using, or the steering wheel and pedals I'm using, are gas and brake.
Oh, this is ridiculous.
I don't have a clutch yet.
I'm literally rolling back down.
I'm laughing at him, but believe me, when I do get the ability to get my...
How do I do this? Right, so...
So you're just laughing because you know it's going to be you pretty soon.
Oh, absolutely. I know exactly what's going to be going on. I'm going to be doing the same thing as he is. Probably trying to figure out a way to do it.
Yeah. Honestly, I mean, the trick of it is you've got to very, very gently lift your foot off the clutch and apply a lot of acceleration. And even then, you might not be. There it is again.
I'd pop her in first and do it that way.
Or, like...
Well, that's what I done, yeah.
Bulldog low. You do have Bulldog Low that you can use. Oh, well, maybe not. You're still a 10-speed transmission, aren't you?
Yeah, I am.
Yeah, you don't have low gear. Like a,
I do.
A super low. Low-range low gear that you get about a mile out of, a mile an hour out of, but it's enough to get forward momentum to hit a higher gear.
No, I probably don't. That's it. I'm out there. I'm out of that now. That was every time.
See, I'm getting adjusted to, believe it or not, I actually like the 13 speed more than the 18 speed. Driving the truck, because the gears seem more familiar to me. Like I said, I've never driven a truck. So I'm thinking more like car, where the most gears I've had in a gearbox was 6. So I know, you know, you take turns second gear mostly. Every once in a while, if it's a sweeping turn like that or roundabout, you could do it in third, that kind of thing, but not...
Can one of you explain to me why it is so common for new drivers to learn and usually buy an automatic over there? Why do they do that?
They're just more prevalent, and they're cheaper. Believe it or not, it used to be...
They're more expensive over here.
Well, it used to be that you would get a discount for getting a manual transmission. So now, not so much. That and people are all about creature comforts. Power windows, power locks. I remember when there was such a thing as power braking. Some of the cars that I originally had, like power-assisted disc brakes, and it was a selling point.
Did you cut out for anyone else or just me?
Who, me?
Oh, there it is. You were kicked from like a too high average ping.
Oh, no.
Who? Me? Or...
No, me. How do I... What, have I got to pull over now and reconnect? How's this work?
Yep.
Alrighty then, that's... I've never had that before.
I've had it one time.
Oh, well. Looks like I'll be, Don't wait on me, guys. Let me quit. That'll save automatically.
I just think that your driver needed a nap.
Yeah, of course, we'd go with that.
You're meaning to ask me what?
I was meaning to ask you, have you ever... Maybe I have asked you. In the time that you were a police officer there, did you ever... What vehicles did you drive?
I started out when the Caprice was the king of the hill, the old school wide body big Caprice.
Right.
And the Crown Victoria was a close second. Both of them, really any department you looked at, had those two vehicles. They were really the only two on the market. Chrysler didn't have anything. Obviously we didn't use any European cars or anything.
Of course not.
Because they're just the import fees and everything else. Then Chevrolet made a critical error in judgment and decided they were going to discontinue the Caprice line, and made a police package, what they called police package Chevrolet Lumina at the time. And it was a giant flop. And I ended up, went to a department that they had the Lumina, and oh, what a dog. I mean, it was so garbage. And then, because the Lumina was a flop as far as market goes, they went with the Impala, which had been around for quite a while now.
One of my favorites, that is.
Not mine per se, because hang on a second, I gotta see where they want the truck. Oh, they want it there.
Wow, you're there already?
Yep.
Alrighty.
Anyway, long story short, we went to the Impala. The Impala was better than the Lumina, but still not...
Right.
Not good enough, in my opinion, to be a police package vehicle. And then we went with
looks like that's gonna be my
obviously
spot.
The Crown Victoria is kind of reigned supreme, and Ford, I have a feeling, is about to learn the same lessons as General Motors did with bringing out the FPI, because it's just not, it's too small. So I think Dodge is kind of cornering the market when it comes to police car. That and Chevrolet bringing the name Priest back brings back a lot of nostalgia for me, but it also brings back, if you look at the Caprice PPV, it is literally, the back door is as long as the front door. I mean, it's a bigger car. Now, is it as wide as the old Caprice? No. But is it still a larger vehicle for patrol? Absolutely. Now, places where you need a smaller car to patrol with, like New York, I can see having luminous downtown metropolitan police departments, definitely the smaller vehicles work, because you don't need them to be able to stretch their legs like a pursuit type vehicle. But yeah, those were the cars that I had. There was one department we had the Plymouth Acclaim, and it was really, who thought that was a good idea? It was a four cylinder.
Hold on a minute, I've got to do some crazy maneuvering right now.
Yeah, that spot sucks.
Oh, and I'm still not there.
Crazy maneuvering, look at this shit.
Where are you guys at?
Walmart, I think.
In Phoenix or?
Cape
Verde.
Verde, isn't it? Yeah.
Okay, I'll come back up to you. Where are you at, Mando?
I'm still parking my trailer.
Oh, nice.
this truck is way too big.
There's a truck stop just west of Camp Verde. You go back toward the highway on the main road out of town.
I'm going to go that way down my yard.
I'm going to meet y'all at the truck there.
All right. Such. I think now if I slowly... Joe, I might be able to do this. It's requiring a lot of maneuvering, but I think I might go ahead and get it.
Well, see, that's the problem with the 900 is the wheelbase on that thing is just gigantic.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Chip, even, I mean, who's a professional driver? Owns his own truck and all that. He's always commented that the W900 in the game drives like a house, and B, in real life, drives like a house.
Yeah. Where have I got to put this thing?
Around the corner back there.
Am I going the right way? I mean, I haven't got the best
of... Yeah.
Right, okay.
Yeah, you need to swing your trailer to your left.
Right.
Yeah, I've got to do something, because the fact of me not really being that experienced backing up a trailer and... The W900 is a house.
Well, the thing about it is the W900 is over the road is probably the pinnacle of truck, because mm-hmm. there's so much room in the cab to live in, basically, that as long as you're going forward, game on. But when you get into someplace, you need a little extra room. Or figure out how to fold it up.
I think I'm almost there with this. I like to say,
Oh, I think I nailed it.
Well, and believe it or not, in Euro Truck, I actually have an easier time backing that truck up.
Well, yeah.
Than I do even this one, which is a shorter wheelbase Kenworth. Just because the wheelbase on it is so short.
All right, here we go.
Yeah, I couldn't do it in first person.
God dang it. You could probably hear my steering wheel right now. I am trying my best to get this. I will do it. I mean, like, shall not be defeated.
All right, so we're meeting up where?
There's a truck stop just west of the highway in Camp Verde.
Hang on a minute.
Oh, okay.
That's where I'm headed to anyway. Because bollocks. I think I'll be able to get in there and get a parking spot by the time they get those parked.
Hell yeah.
Oh, I'm parked. I'm just enjoying watching him try to do it now because I tormented myself by choosing this, and now I got to watch someone else do it.
Oh, mate, don't, you know, I mean, I'm almost pulling my hair out at this point.
Yeah, I've been there a few times.
Now, I will say, my experience backing the trailer up started off, my dad has a small farm and has a small farm tractor. And he had a trailer ball on the front of the tractor, and I was able to watch when I turned the wheels how a trailer reacted. So it was a major learning point. He would never let me back up a trailer until I got good enough with it actually going forward where I could keep an eye on it and not worry about the tractor getting in the way. So... And then eventually I got good enough with it that he trusted me backing up his boat and everything else.
That will do.
You got it.
Good lord. That was more...
You did better than I did.
I did?
Surprisingly, yeah.
I mean, surprise elite.
Well, I mean, I live on a farm, so I back trailers up even into the shed and stuff, so I know how trailers react quite well.
Well, the thing about it is getting a trailer that's 53 feet long around a corner, did he have to park up next to the building or out away from it?
Literally sweating from doing that.
he was a little bit away, but it was right up along the fence.
Okay, yeah, he was at the far spot.
I hate that spot.
The fun one is where you've got to get the trailer pinned right up against the wall in the dock at Walbert. Try doing that with a W900 and a 53 footer.
Impossible.
Unable.
We're gonna go ahead and give it some welly now. I like driving without the trailer.
Trucker.exe has stopped responding. Please give me another spot.
Right. Where are we? Oh, we gave it some welly. Yeah, we did. Although I think I've overshot.
I only used up half a tank.
Yeah, I need to fill up as well, buddy. Reversing in now, because why not?
Yeah. I see ya.
Oh, I'm about to get on the highway and hammer it towards you guys.
Yeah. I think I can see Run actually coming now.
Yep, I see you.
Yeah, I see him.
Alright, we're gonna go ahead, turn the wheel. Where is it? Ah, here it is. There she is.
Oh, they need to open up more than one pump, because this is ridiculous.
Yeah. They could easily have...
Three.
Four, I'm thinking, with the one over... Well, yeah, three. Three, well, yeah.
It's worse than the cashier lanes at Walmart. They may have 40 lines, but only two are going to be open.
Yeah.
Notice that, too. And, of course, Hoosier is decided to back in... Make it look like he went the wrong way in a one-way alley. You're backed in to a parking spot that is meant to pull in with a trailer, jack wagon.
Fully aware.
Oh, the hammer is down.
There's Grace. Monkey see, monkey do.
I just don't... Well, I mean, I thought I'd do some donuts here. I mean,
it's a friggin' truck rodeo.
No, I'm kidding. I'm backing it up so I can actually. Here we go. Right. Well,
I'm gonna hit this spot out here and I'll let y'all do donuts or whatever you want to do.
Whereabouts do you go then? Is there other spots down there? Is there?
There's spots all the way around this island here.
Because, I mean, I've gone for... Alright.
There you go, whoops. Ryan.
Forgot to shift.
What do you mean you stopped the engine?
Well, there's Manly. It didn't take him long to get here.
Told you I was
putting the hammer
down.
He was breaking the speed limit.
Totally was not.
Have I ever shot? Yeah.
You're in the driveway, but if you keep going around, there's more parking spots over there.
Yeah, we'll probably go with one of them.
Well, guys, I really hope you enjoyed that. It was fun. Not quite as sporadic or crazy as the live stream we did last time, but fun, nonetheless. Interesting conversation along the way, some interesting technical, or not even technical difficulties this time, just, issues driving.
Operator malfunctions?
Yeah. Operator malfunctions. But, I'm looking forward to doing some more of these, and I will see everybody in the next one.